So the things that the red require. They require succinct and direct input. They require decisiveness. They want issues to be closed once they're addressed, not to be keep being brought up. They want to have their observations, their thoughts listened to. They want agreement of what is at stake and the desired outcomes at the beginning before we kind of get into discussions. They want an element of autonomy. They want to be able to challenge what has been said. They want the freedom to rewrite the rules if the rules are no longer serving the purpose. And they want to maintain that focus on the purpose and the goal throughout the meeting. Some of the blind spots that everybody needs to be aware of from the red behavioral preferences, their intolerance of time wasters. When we're discussing unrelated issues or feelings and emotions. Another blind spot is they tend not to have an awareness or give consideration for the impact that their words and actions may be having on other people. They don't always offer sufficient support or recognition to other people. And there is also a tendency of a red behavioral preference to kind of push for a conclusion as speedily as possible without necessarily getting all the information out there. If we then look at the requirements of our yellow behavioral preference, the yellow behavioral preference, they like people to have positive mindsets, to start from the footing that the resolution can be achieved. They like the approval and recognition of their efforts from other people. They want the flexibility to explore possibilities. They want opportunities to bend the rules if need be. They want the freedom to run with ideas, not being reined in too quickly. They like to think outside the box to find new solutions, novel ways of doing things, working things out. And they like an environment that values individuality and allows them the freedom to do their own thing. Not everybody has to do the same thing. What are the things that they are looking for in order to resolve a conflict situation? Some of their blind spots that we need to be aware of. They do tend to take criticism personally. They don't always value people who tend to stick to the rules. They don't always see the necessity, for there are times when we do need to stick to the rules. They may become frustrated with long, drawn out, messy situations that for them, there is no easy solution to. And they also might have a tendency towards avoiding conflict, simply to escape the burden of it. With the yellow behavioral preference, they don't like anything that is kind of go on for a long time, that is going to weigh them down, to take away that freedom that they like. The green behavioral preference then. They require to see that everybody is being respected and that each individual's beliefs and values are being respected. They like to see acknowledgement of the emotions and feelings of the people in the meeting, involved in the conflict. They want to see or receive appreciation for the work that they do in bringing people together, in trying to maintain that kind of more harmonious environment. They want to feel valued and respected as an individual. They want to see that harmonious environment that they're constantly striving for themselves. They want to also feel that their dislike for conflict is respected by other people. They want to have an overview of kind of who and what the conflict is all about and who's involved in this conflict. And they like to have time to process the impact of the conflict on the people involved. Now, some of their blind spots to be aware of. They can be influenced by what other people want rather than their own wants and requirements. They may actually avoid conflict to try and escape unpleasant consequences. Again, they take criticism personally. And they do tend to find it quite hard to be able to distance themselves from conflict. They become emotionally involved in the conflict. So with our blue behavioural preference then, for them they require respect for the rules and procedures. They want precise and relevant facts that describe the issues accurately. They want the opportunity to be able to reflect on the proceedings, the format, the process. They want some respect for what they would perceive to be common sense. Now, as we know, there is no such thing as common sense. We've all got our own version of common sense. But they want to receive respect for what they perceive to be common sense, which is rational, logical, sequential kind of thinking. We want to be able to see the sequence, the process. Willingness to remain objective when discussing the situation. So again, they don't like people bringing in lots of emotion and personal kind of feelings to the situation. And they want time to be able to discuss the issues in detail. They don't want to feel hurried and rushed. So some of their blind spots, they may have difficulty dealing with ambiguity if things are not clear. They don't necessarily value people who want to spend time striving for harmony above principles. They don't always consider the impact of their comments on other people. There may be a tendency for them to overcomplicate, to overthink a situation. And they may want to take too long exploring what the conflict is all about rather than focusing on the solution and resolving the conflict.